Shalom, I'm Messianic Rabbi Zev Porat, and welcome to a special outreach update from Israel. We're living in exciting and prophetic times. There's never been a generation closer to the second coming of Jesus Yeshua, the Lamb of God, than this generation.
Hallelujah.
We're not setting any dates, but we know that the time is near.
Yes.
We know that the veil is being lifted. 2 Corinthians chapter 3, verse 16, and Jews are being saved in Israel and around the world like never before. There is a revival in Israel. There is a hunger for truth. As the Jews in Israel and around the world are preparing for the Passover, they're cleaning their homes, they're scrubbing their homes, they're changing their dishes, they're boiling dishes, because they believe, the ones who don't believe in Yeshua, that based on the Bible, if you have leaven in your house during Passover, unleavened bread, you will be cut off from Israel. And they base it on Exodus chapter 12, verse 15. 7 days you shall eat unleavened bread. On the first day you shall remove leaven out of your houses. For if anyone eats what is leavened from the first day until the seventh day, that person shall be cut off from Israel. And because they do not believe in Yeshua and Jesus as Lord and Savior, as God, as the Lamb of God, they believe that if they have a breadcrumb in their home, they will be cut off from Israel. As believers in Yeshua, in Jesus, we understand that the leaven represents sin. And in the Old Testament, it was a foreshadow in order to bring him in to Messiah Yeshua, Jesus. Leaven in the Bible represents sin. And the wages of sin is death. And that's what it means. If you have leaven in your houses, you will be cut off from Israel. Because we understand as believers in Yeshua, in Jesus, that eternal Israel is the new Jerusalem, the new heavens, the new earth. And all those who do not call on Yeshua, on Jesus, as their personal Savior, who do not believe that he died on the tree on the cross for your sins, rose on the third day, and by his blood, all who repent and believe will have eternal life. And the leaven taken out of their home through Messiah Yeshua, all those shall be cut off from eternal Israel.
Amen.
And that's what the Bible verse is speaking about. Yeah. Paul, under the inspiration of the Holy Spirit, writes about this. 1 Corinthians chapter 5, verse 7. Get rid of the old leaven, that you may be a new unleavened batch, as you really are. For Christ, Yeshua, our Passover lamb, has been sacrificed. So we can see over here that in the Old Testament, removing the leaven from the house was just a foreshadow of Yeshua. Only he's unleavened. And through him, we become righteous. Through him, we become unleavened. Once again, showing that leaven represents sin. And when it says to remove all leaven from your houses, otherwise you will be cut off from Israel, this is what it's speaking about. The wages of sin is death. And only through Messiah Yeshua, Mashiach, the unleavened bread, as he did in the Lord's Supper, taking that unleavened bread, that matzah, and breaking it and saying, this is my body broken for you. That's what he was speaking about. Yeshua is the Lamb of God. Yeshua is the only one that can remove the leaven. And all those who do not call on Yeshua as their personal Savior will be cut off from Israel. There's nothing wrong with cleaning your houses for Passover, but having a piece of bread in your house is not going to remove you from Israel. What is going to remove you from Israel is sin. All of us have fallen short of the glory, but through him we become righteous. Through him we become priests, because he's our high priest. How do we remove the leaven from our house? 1 Corinthians chapter 3, verse 16. Do you not know that you are God's temple and that God's Spirit dwells in you? And thus we can see the deep meaning, what it meant in the Old Testament to remove the leaven. It was a foreshadow of Jesus Yeshua. They also based the unleavened bread on the bread of affliction. Deuteronomy chapter 16, verse 3. You shall eat no leavened bread with it. 7 days you shall eat it with unleavened bread, the bread of affliction. For you came out of the land of Egypt in haste, that all the days of your life you shall remember the day when you came out of the land of Egypt. As believers in Yeshua and Jesus, we understand that Egypt represents the world. And the foreshadow was making it to the promised land, the new heavens, the new earth, the new Yerushalayim, the new Jerusalem. And the bread of affliction, the matzah, the unleavened bread, is pointing to Yeshua, the Messiah. This is my body, broken for you. Do this in remembrance of me. But Jews who do not believe in Yeshua, in Jesus, and don't have the Holy Spirit, don't see the full picture. Yeshua said in that Passover meal, Do this in remembrance of me. Asuzot beyadai, bezachri. And the bread of affliction is pointing direct to Messiah Yeshua Mashiach. Isaiah 53, verse 4. Surely he took up our pain and bore our suffering. Yet we considered him punished by God, stricken by him, and afflicted. He is the bread of affliction. He is the bread of life. He is the Lamb of God who takes away the sin of the world. He is the Pesach, the Passover. He is the matzah, the unleavened bread. And he is the one that frees us from bondage, Egypt, and brings us into the promised land, the new heavens, the new earth, the new Yerushalayim, the new Jerusalem. As the team were praying, I began to ask people, why are you cleaning your homes before the Passover? Why are you changing your dishes, scrubbing the floors, the roofs, and the windows for weeks? A very religious Orthodox man was approaching. I asked him, are you preparing for the Passover? He said, of course. This is the most important time of year. I'm a rabbi of a synagogue. Not only do I have to prepare my home, but I have to help the people in my synagogue prepare. It's a busy time of year. I introduced myself. He introduced himself as Rabbi Yaniv Yu. Why are you interested in asking me? He asked. I told Rabbi Yaniv, because I also prepare for Pesach, for Passover, and unleavened bread. But I don't clean my house for 3 weeks and wash all the dishes out. The rabbi was puzzled and asked, how can that be? Then you're not prepared for Passover. And you're putting yourself in danger. I asked Rabbi Yaniv, Lemata mitkaven, what do you mean? He said, it's written in the Bible, in the Torah. It's written that if you have leaven in your house, you'll be cut off from Israel. There's a danger here. I told Rabbi Yaniv, I'm familiar with the Bible verses. Let's read them together. Praise Yeshua, Jesus. Right there in the middle of the street, we were having a Bible study. But before we read the Bible verse, I want to ask you a question. He said, ask. I asked the rabbi, what did God tell Adam would happen if he eats from the tree of knowledge of good and evil? Rabbi Yaniv said, they will die. I asked the rabbi, would you agree dying is considered being cut off from Israel? He said, absolutely. Would you agree that dying here in this context represents sin? He said, absolutely. I said, so based on your own testimony and agreement, we can both agree that the wages of sin is death. He said, yes, in a low voice, and started to get uncomfortable. I said, with that understanding, let's read the Bible. I turned the Bible to Exodus chapter 12, verse 15, and read together in Hebrew with Rabbi Yaniv. 7 days you shall eat unleavened bread. On the first day you shall remove leaven out of your houses. For if anyone eats what is leaven from the first day until the seventh day, that person shall be cut off from Israel. So we can see here, just like in the garden, if they ate from that tree of the knowledge of good and evil, they would be cut off from Israel. And here we see the same words, the same context. If anybody has leaven in their home, they will be cut off from Israel. And the question has to be asked, is this referring to cleaning your homes for weeks, making sure there's no breadcrumbs? Or is there a much deeper biblical meaning here? This rabbi of the synagogue was puzzled by the question. He did not answer. The Holy Spirit was working. The prayers of the believers were working. I told Rabbi Yaniv, leaven represents sin in the Bible. And God says, if you have any sin in your houses, you'll be cut off from Israel. Just like he told Adam in the garden. The day you eat from the tree of the knowledge of good and evil, you will be cut off. You will die. And so there's nothing wrong with cleaning the houses for Passover. It's nice. And that is not what's going to determine if you're cut off from Israel or not. Finally, the rabbi turned to me and said, but what about the bread of affliction? I asked the rabbi, would you agree that that bread of affliction was unleavened bread? He said, absolutely. I said, let's turn our Bibles and read it together. I turned the Bible to Deuteronomy chapter 16, verse 3, and read together in Hebrew with the rabbi. You shall eat no leavened bread with it. 7 days you shall eat it with unleavened bread, the bread of affliction. For you came out of the land of Egypt in haste, that all the days of your life you shall remember the day when you came out of the land of Egypt. And I asked the rabbi, this is the Bible verse about the bread of affliction. What brought us out of Egypt was the blood on the lintels of the doorposts of the home. Without that blood, the Israelites would not be freed from bondage, would not go through the Red Sea, and would not eat the bread of affliction here. Can we agree that it was the blood of the lamb on the lintels of the doorposts of the home that freed the Israelites from bondage? He said, yes. So when we remember being freed from Egypt, We need to remember that God did it through the blood of the Lamb. Once again, the rabbi didn't answer. The Holy Spirit was working. And the only way to take the leaven out of our lives, out of our homes, is through the blood of the Lamb. At that moment, the rabbi said, I think I need to leave. I asked Rabbi Aniv, you said that I'm in danger if I have leaven in my house. Can you tell me why? At that moment, something supernatural happened. The rabbi not only could not answer me, but he could not move. It was like something was gluing him to the ground. It was time for the full gospel. I told Rabbi Aniv, that bread of affliction is the Messiah, Mashiach, the Lamb of God. Everything that happened in Egypt and happened at that time was just a foreshadow. So when Messiah would come, you would know it. It would be a sign. Finally, he asked, where does the Bible say that the Messiah is the bread of affliction? I turned the Bible to Isaiah 53. We read the whole chapter, but especially Isaiah 53, verse 4, as we read it several times over and over again. Surely he took our pain and bore our suffering. Yet we consider him punished by God, stricken by him, and afflicted. He is the bread of affliction. In Egypt, that blood of the Lamb was a temporary freedom. It was a foreshadow. Messiah came once and for all. The bread of affliction was afflicted, was pierced for our iniquities once and for all, died on the tree on the cross for our sins, rose on the third day, and by his blood, the blood of the Lamb, all are set free to the eternal Yerushalayim, eternal Jerusalem, and will never be cut off from Israel. And his name is Yeshua, Jesus. The Holy Spirit was keeping the rabbi there. He didn't move anymore. I began reading several Bible verses together with him, and once again, reading Exodus and reading Isaiah 53. He kept on saying in Hebrew over and over again, Mani ase, mani ase. What will I do? What will I do? He knew the truth. He couldn't deny the Bible verses, but he was terrified. He began to see that the exact opposite of what he understood about being cut off from Israel was the truth. I told Rabbi Aniv not to fear. I was once an Orthodox Jew like him, and I came to know that Yeshua, Jesus, is the bread of life. Yeshua is the Lamb of God. Yeshua is the matzah, the unleavened bread. And Yeshua is the true Pesach, the true Passover. Se'a Elohim, the Lamb of God. I turn the Bible to Psalms 27, verse 1. The Lord is my light and my salvation. Whom shall I fear? The Lord is the stronghold of my life. Of whom shall I be afraid? In Hebrew, it reads like this. The Lord is my light and my Yeshua. Whom shall I fear? Yeshua, the Lamb of God, is calling you. This Pesach, this Passover, is your deliverance. He was scared and did not want to exchange contact information. But praise Yeshua, I know the synagogue that he belongs to and will be paying him a visit. We will continue to pray for the rabbi, his synagogue, and all those that heard the gospel, that they would come to know that Yeshua, Jesus, is God. Yeshua is the Lamb of God who takes away the sin of the world. One thing is certain, Rabbi Yaniv Vur and all those that heard the gospel will never be the same again. And for this, we give all the glory to the King of Kings and Lord of Lords, Jesus Yeshua. Let's continue to stand together as the one new man, Ephesians 2:15. Work the harvest
God
together. Bring the gospel back to Jerusalem and go home. Until next time, I'm Messianic Rabbi Zev Porat, sending you blessings from Israel in the mighty name of the King of Kings and Lord of Lords, Aryeh Yehuda, the Lion of the tribe of Judah, Se'a Elohim, the Lamb of God, Jesus Yeshua. Amen.